Hey guys, welcome back to another video, the final pre-season preview from me. If I sound a bit croaky, I've been a bit unwell today and I'm not feeling great, but you know, the show must go on, so I'm still here. So today I'll be covering the Western Bulldogs, the final team, obviously alphabetically, coached by Luke Beveridge, another Clarko's commando, and captained by Easton Wood at $23 for the premiership. Odds, it still could happen, like odds-wise, $23, but I don't think it will really. They've got quite a few losses. All three retirements that they have are all big hits, and also one of the trades out that they have, or the only trade out that they have, I should say, is pretty big. So we'll get straight into the ins. So from Port Adelaide, Jackson Trengrove. From Fremantle, Hayden Crozier. And from Brisbane, Josh Shackey. From the draft itself, Aaron Norton, Ed Richards, and Callum Porter. And from the rookie draft, Billy Gowers. So those three trades in, Trengove, Crozier, and Shackey, I think will be pretty good pickups. They're all pretty good pickups. I don't think they're ever going to win Brownlows, of course, but they're definitely good, solid players, and hopefully play some good footy for the Dogs. Moving on to the outs. As I said before, three huge retirements in Matthew Boyd, Bob Murphy, and Travis Cloak. Bob Murphy hasn't been playing too much lately, but they all are quite big hits, I think. And also with the delistings of Josh Pruden, Declan Hamilton, Tristan Tweedy, and Stuart Cramery. He's a bit of a name I wasn't really expecting to see in the delistings. And also the massive trade out that they have from Jake Stringer is off to Essendon. Huge hit, Stringer is, the three retirements, but with the non-retirements is Jake Stringer, and that's just a massive hit. The package, as I said in my Essendon video, the package deserves that name, and I just think he's going to do really well for Essendon, which was obviously really well for not the Dogs, which they'll miss, but hopefully they can adjust. Two injuries to start the season. Lin Jong last year had a knee reconstruction in June last year. And obviously he won't be starting the season because it is the full year that's needed. And also Liam Picken had a head knock a couple of weeks ago, and he's out indefinitely, which is quite scary for him. So my thoughts are with him, and hopefully he can take the time he needs. I really don't want him to come back before his time. I just want them to keep him out till he's, 200%. He's not 100%. I want him to be 200% healthy before they risk him back. I just think head knocks and head injuries are just something that he can't play around with. That's obviously why he's out indefinitely. Hope he can recover quickly, but obviously take the time he needs. And we'll see how he goes. Hopefully he can be back. Round one is GWS. I think it'll be a Giants win. Not 100% sure, and obviously they're two top teams, but the Dogs are a bit further down, but they're two relatively good teams. But I just think that the Giants are too strong because of the losses that the Dogs have. I just think the Giants will be too good in this instance. So, yeah, that's my preview of the Dogs. As I said, it's a bit of a short one because, as I said, I'm quite unwell, so a bit of a short one, so I apologise for that. But, tomorrow I'll be posting a bit of a, or depending on my health, posting a bit of a preview of things that have happened since I've started my videos, you know, if things have happened with clubs after I've done my preview, then I'll be covering that in tomorrow's video, some things that have happened, and yeah, I'll see you guys then. Alright, thanks guys.